After a few days of battling bad weather in Hakone, we were finally on our way once more. This next leg of our journey would see us travelling 430 kilometres to the bustling city of Osaka. From there, we'd be heading to Nagasaki for a few days, before making a brief stay at Kyoto, then on to Osaka once more, before finally bouncing on to home. Killing time before our room became available, we'd spent a few hours exploring the local streets and department stores before finally checking in. The Cross Hotel would sit in stark contrast to the ryokan we'd left behind in Hakone.
This is cozy. Cozy.
So this is Bridget's list of what we can do in Osaka. As you can probably see, the list is fairly small and mainly consists of food.
So we've stopped for a bit. What's the score?
Legs really hurt.
Your legs really hurt.
Just for a minute, and then we'll go and get some food.
Food.
Despite the hotel's simple functionality, you could think of it as a supercharged Premier Inn, I guess. It was situated only a very short walk from Dontonbori Canal. Renowned for its street food, we were keen to get stuck in.
Not a huge fan of octopus balls. I mean, I'm fine with them. No, I am fine with them. You're looking at me weirdly. I'll eat them, but I'll eat most things. But these are the best ones I've had, easily.
And if you're going to eat balls, they really need to be the very finest balls.
They need to be the finest balls that you can get hold of, really.
And these. And, you know, this view.
It's working.
This view's not bad, really, is it?
Taking in the spectacular sunset and ticking off a few items on Bridget's to-do list, we then went in search of a bar, preferably one with an electronic dance machine. As fairly introverted characters, going into a quiet bar always presents somewhat of a challenge. Despite the language barrier though, things went surprisingly well, the game of darts being an additional bonus and not something we'd actually sought out.
I got it.
Unfortunately, the camera doesn't lie, and retrospectively, that wasn't the bullseye we initially both thought it was. Needless to say, the game resulted in a firm victory for Bridget.
Congratulations. Mm-hmm. Well done. Mm-hmm. You are the darts champion.
Hi.
Okay, so what is it you think you're eating?
Chicken.
Chicken. But you're not sure what part of the chicken? The chicken. Mm. Are you smelling it? Chicken. Shall I ask you what this is? Really?
No.
Is it chicken?
It's chicken.
Our walk back to the hotel took us back over the canal. It's interesting that Dontonbori has always reminded me of some of the montage imagery used in 1995's anime, Ghost in the Shell. The neon lights and angular canal would be something we'd be drawn back to time and time again during our short stay in the city.
Feathers around this time.
We were up early the next morning. Osaka Castle was only a 45-minute walk from our hotel, and it seemed like a good excuse to get some exercise and explore the city further.
Big stones.
We can't work out how they build it.
How did they build it? Those stones are huge.
Not before long, food was back on the agenda.
Well, the Harajuku one was a bit different though, because it wasn't wrapped so much.
Ah, okay. So is this going to be better or worse?
Well, it's got some other, I think it's got some red bean in the mochi.
Good? Mm-hmm. Ah, yeah, mm-hmm. It is different. Nice.
By early evening, we were back at Dontonbori Canal.
It's good. Back in the hotel room.
Why are we back in the hotel room?
We didn't take out enough money.
Because Bridget forgot to get out.
We didn't take out enough money.
Having eaten our own body weight in food, we decided to head out and explore some of the local bars and arcades.
You've got a moustache.
I know that.
Your hair ready?
No.
I'm taking this very seriously. Are they good?
They're tiny, I can't see.
Brilliant.
At this stage in our adventure, I was beginning to think that Bridger had developed a serious problem concerning the crane games.
It's got you now. Well done.
How much
winner. That, how much that cost you?
I don't know.
As we made our way back to the hotel, we came across a Rolling Stones theme bar called Fanny Mae's. Bridget, as a fan, was keen to explore. The owner was enthusiastic and accommodating. He even seemed more than a little impressed with Bridget's limited Japanese. Eating okonomiyaki was yet to be ticked off our to-do list. During our conversation, Bridget asked the owner if he, as a local, would recommend somewhere we could try it. He jotted down just one name on a piece of paper, an establishment simply called Dan. Back to our hotel room saw us once again detoured by Dontonbori Canal. Some affection, we came to refer to this section of the canal as Goth Corner. We were up at sunrise. Despite a few revelers still yet to find their way home, the atmosphere was calm, and the canal was almost unrealistically still. The Damaru Umeda department store was just a short walk from the hotel. It offered some great views of the city, amongst other things. Making our way back to the canal, we decided to set about locating the restaurant recommendation we'd been given the night before. Google Translate is an absolute game changer. However, trying to locate a restaurant called Dan amongst all the kanji was proving exceptionally difficult. Eventually, we struck gold. Dan had been located. Exhausted by our endeavor, we set about eating more food.
それでは皆様、トンボリリバークルーズ出発です。みんなでね、バイバーイ。行ってきます。
My mother always says, a holiday is not a holiday until you've had a boat trip. This would be our second boat trip.
It's video, so just do what you do.
Be natural.
We'd promised ourselves prior to coming back to Japan that we'd take the odd moment just to sit and watch the world go by. Finding ourselves with a pint of beer by the canal was the perfect way to round off the afternoon. As evening drew in, we made our way to Dan.
The lift smells nice.
The lift does smell nice.
Are you excitement?
So much excitement.
You're so much excitement.
So much excitement.
Okay. Let's hope so. Now that is the good shit.
So gone.
It may seem excessive, but despite our full stomachs, we headed back to the canal to score some more food. We'd spotted a whiskey bar in the basement of the department store we'd visited earlier that day, and with night closing in, it seemed a shame not to pay it a visit.
For relaxing times, make it Suntory times.
More intensity.
We'd be back in Osaka in a few days' time, but tomorrow would see us moving on to Nagasaki.